brain of the computer. Which among the following is the brain of the computer? Let's move to the answer. CPU, Central Processing Unit, is the brain of the computer. This is a very easy question. Now let's move to the second question. Which language is directly understood by the computer? Computer understood which among the following languages? Machine language, assembly, high level, medium level, none of these. And the answer is, computer understand machine level, machine language. Now let's move to the next question. ALU stands for? Let's move to the answer. Arithmetic logic unit. Now the next question. CPU receives data from? From where does CPU receive the data? It receives from input unit or from main memory or secondary memory or from all of these or from none of these. Answer is, CPU receives data from the main memory. Actually main memory is also known as primary memory. So CPU receives its data from the main memory or primary memory. Which unit performs the logical operations? Let's move to the answer. ALU performs the logical operations. ALU, arithmetic logic unit, performs the arithmetic and logical operations. Next question. Which among the following acts as central nervous system? This we have covered in theory portion. Let's move to the answer. Control unit acts as central nervous system. Next question. Why there is a need of secondary storage? We already have primary storage in our computers or laptops. Then why there is a need of secondary storage? Okay, let's move to the answer. Because it stores more data. Because primary storage is generally expensive and it has small capacity, which we have covered in theory portion. So for storing more data, we use secondary storage. Next question. Which among the following is secondary storage? Have a look. And the answer, all of these, floppy disk, hard disk, magnetic tapes, all of these are secondary storage. Fastest memory among these, which among the following is the fastest memory? Let's move to the answer. Cache memory. Cache memory is the fastest memory. Okay. This is an important question. On which principle cache memory works? Okay, let's move to the answer. Cache memory works on the locality of reference principle. In locality of reference principle, related storage locations are frequently accessed depending upon the memory access method. Now let's move to the next question. Cache memory works between. This is also important. Where does cache memory works? Cache memory works between CPU and RAM. Next question. Which among the following is part of instruction cycle? This also we have covered in second portion of the computer architecture theory portion. Answer is all of these. Next one. USB stands for. Nowadays we all use USB port and it stands for. Now the answer is universal serial bus. Now the next question. A USB port can connect maximum of how many devices? This we have covered in theory portion. And I also told that it is very important. It can connect maximum of 127 devices. Which port is known as printer port? Which among the following is known as printer port? The answer is parallel port. Now, SCSI stands for. SCSI is pronounced as SCSI. SCSI stands for. It stands for Small Computer System Interface. Actually, SCSI is a set of standards for physically connecting and transferring data between computers and devices. Next one. In which register intermediate arithmetic results are stored? This is an important question. Accumulator is the right answer. We have already covered this in theory question. What is MIMD? Let's move to the answer. It's multiple instruction, multiple data. Second option. Next one. The communication line between CPU and peripheral devices is? Let's move to the answer. Bus. Now let's move to the last question. Which company leads the microprocessor business? This I think all of us know. And the answer is Intel. Thank you. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more video, and also comment your score in the comment box.